Hello, I'm E.B. Stevenson, and welcome to this EBTV video. There's a lot of argument about what school was the most controversial in the history of education in St. Louis County. The school I'm talking about is one that I attended for 2 years before I graduated from high school. According to Bert of Bert TV, this school was not originally intended to be a permanent school when the Ladue School District had the building constructed sometime in the 1950s. It was meant to be a temporary school until Old Bottom School, located on Old Bottom Road across from Stacy Park and Olivet, was ready for students to attend class. The school I'm talking about is Dielman School, which was on Dielman Road north of Olive Boulevard in Olivet. And just a few blocks away from that, from the site of that school, is Elmwood Park, a neighborhood that has seen its share of problems over the years. The special school district took control of the Dielman building in 1980, transferring it a program called departmental, which was mainly academics and social skills being taught, from Bridgeton School. That school no longer exists either. It was taken by the expansion of St. Louis Lambert International Airport. Now the place was entirely devoted to the teaching of academic subjects as well as improving one's social skills, since most of the students had were not only slow learners but also had trouble adjusting to a traditional school environment. But this is where the controversy comes in. It was in 1982 that it was combined with the program at Mark Twain School in Florissant, which special at least from the Ferguson-Florissant School District to replace Moline School, which was leased from the School District of Riverview Gardens. That place also had a lot of students who had trouble adjusting to a traditional school setting. And also moving in with the Dielman program was something called the COPE program, which pretty much was the worst of the worst of students in St. Louis County. A number of students had run-ins with the law. I came to Dielman School in August of 1983, and several students that I went to school with I knew from previous assignments. For example, I've known Bert Wurtenberg, who runs the Bert TV channel on YouTube, since our days at Child Center of Our Lady, which was then Child Center of Our Lady of Grace in Normandy. And also in that school was Marcus Stamps. And as it turned out, they were at Dielman. I also knew Don Murphy from my days at McNair Elementary School in Hazelwood, where we had a self-contained classroom. That was the classroom where everything was taught in one room, although the students could go out a few hours a day for art, music, or physical education. A couple of other students I knew from Riverview East Middle School, where I was in a self-contained classroom there. I only go with the initials, the last initial, Norvell T. and John G. That's how special one wanted us to say that. There were some people that were the worst. One student that I went to school with, a Dealman from my Ackerman school days, was a fellow named Steve Davidson. When we were kids, we used to throw the football around in the hallway. By the time I got to Dealman, he had become a drug dealer. And that information I got from Bert Wurtenberg. In 1993, he committed a drug-related triple murder, which got him a life sentence. A number of other students have served time behind bars after their days at Dealman. I know of one who has served time for assault, and another one who served time for robbery. The Dealman that I went to school with was called a career development center. There were fewer rooms for academics. A lot of the rooms were dedicated to the learning of job skills, like the construction trades and arts and crafts. The automotive trade, framing, printing. And also food service. There are some positive things that came from that too. My homeroom teacher was Mrs. Fine, and she was Jewish, and I started learning a little more about Judaism through Mrs. Fine. We had two other teachers who were Jewish. One of the coaches, Coach Tesler, and the teacher in charge of the food service program, Ms. Goldman. And that really broadened my perspective a little bit. One of my other teachers was a part-time fashion model, Ms. Gooding. I had a romantic crush on her, but became pretty good friends with her. And another teacher I had, Mr. Ganuzzi, who still keeps in touch with Bird of Bert TV. He has also served as an activist in the National Education Association. When I was attending Dealman, the principal was a fellow named Jim DeMartini, and he was very straightforward and very tough on us, but was a tough love. And he really straightened me out. And the program director was Richard Lawrence, and he also helped straighten me out. And in my senior year at Dealman, I even helped out in the office. helping take care of the mail and answering phone calls. It was also during that last year that I studied for the GED because my parents knew that something negative was going to happen. My first year at Dielman, I learned how to drive a car. And I passed my driving test on the first try. And it turned into something that relaxes me. You know, driving can be hectic. But for me, driving along the roads, especially country roads, relaxes me. When I graduated from Dielman in 1985, I graduated at the top of my class, and I took the most difficult route, and that was nearly acing the GED. Out of 270 questions, I only missed 9. It was during the final weeks of my study for the GED that I fell in love with an 8th grader, whom I would later become engaged to marry. But I'm not going to say her name because I could get into trouble with certain people. After I finished my senior year, was the same time that Mr. DeMartini became director of the tech schools. And Dielman School started getting written up in the local press, but not in a good way. The turnover rate was around 30% the whole time I was there. But after I graduated, it shot up to 86%. And the number of times, you know, the police were called in every once in a while when I was a student, but the Olivet police got called in more frequently after I left that situation to go on to community college. In fact, I was the only student to go to Dielman go on to community college, in this case St. Louis Community College at Florissant Valley, where I studied communication arts. And I was also the only one to go on to a 4-year university, Southern Illinois University, Edwardsville, where I completed a degree in geography. Now, the Dielman environment was not a very good environment to learn in. The place was already a dump by the time I arrived. And the Special School District of St. Louis County got tired of all the negativity that Dielman was shuttered after the 1992-93 school year. Shortly after the closure, the property was bought by developers. The school was torn down to make way for luxury townhomes. The existence of Dielman School apparently drove down property values in the subdivision near the school. Although it took a very negative environment to shake me up, it was an experience that I learned a lot from. At Dielman, I also got my first exposure to scratch music, or dance mixes, and to rap music. And the rap, big rappers at the time were Run DMC, Houdini, Curtis Blow. This was long before the Beastie Boys and Coolio and NWA. I last visited Dielman in 1987. That was after class at Flow Valley. The Dielman experience may have changed me. It was an experience that few people would ever go through. Although I had good teachers, the environment left something to be desired. Most of the people I graduated with went into the trades or into other areas of endeavor, like food service or construction trades, and into the automotive trade. I was the only one that continued to challenge myself intellectually. That is, in the official sense, through colleges and universities. A lot of them continued their education life through the School of Hard Knocks, and Dielman was the closest thing you had to the School of Hard Knocks. The school may be gone, but it has left its mark in the history of education in St. Louis County. But the one thing that came up from the closure of the LN I did not agree with was trying to integrate students with numerous problems into our regular schools. And that's really given the public schools a lot of guff, in my opinion. This is E.B. Stevenson for EBTV. Thank you for watching.